law firm of Bose McKinney and Evans, and the former executive director of the Indiana Land Resource Council, which is a nine-member group appointed by the governor to assist state and local decision makers with land use and planning tools and policies. I've been retained by a group of landowners that live here in Henry County. They've hired me to speak tonight in regards to the county's land use ordinance with respect to WECS. My clients want an ordinance that facilitates economic opportunities for county residents, and therefore they recommend that the current ordinance, which meets the stated purpose that it was drafted under, which is to facilitate economic opportunities for the county and its residents, is sufficient. It was drafted based on thoughtful review and adequately protects properties and parties without need for any amendments or change. However, if the county does determine that changes should be made, such changes should reflect findings from a large body of peer-reviewed and independent data. And it is important that the county not create a moratorium, an effective moratorium, by overly burdensome setbacks. The current 1,500-foot setback from residential zones, which is a WECS tower to property line setback, is sufficient. My client also supports the current safety design and installation and the noise and vibration standards. Those standards meet the stated purpose of preserving the public health, safety, and general welfare of Henry County. And they also support the current use of road services provisions, operation and maintenance decommissioning plan, and liability insurance provisions of the WECS ordinance. My clients don't want additional restrictions on what they can do with their property. The county made the decision to create a WECS ordinance that invited investment into the county and what development should occur in places where it makes the most economic and operational sense. So my clients would like to see wind energy pursued responsibly in the county and that a balance is struck that would allow development where it makes the most sense to help bring jobs and revenue to the area.